it's time to get back to business here. Hour number three on this Monday night for you. You know what that means. We're going to talk about many things, certainly environmental, and Fukushima will be on the table as well, as we talk to Dana Durnford and Yoichi Shimatsu. Yoichi, where are you? Do we know? I mean,
well,
I don't know.
I'm still hanging out in Thailand, trying to chill out, get my health back. You know, a lot of people I know are feeling not so good, tired, chronic fatigue. That's really one of the first signs of the onset of.
When you were in the States, you were getting that, or are you hearing that in Thailand?
People in California, people down by Brisbane, people all over, are getting Pacific Basin, Fukushima's effects, despite the denials from the various paid off groups, one of the conclusions I'm coming to, this whole cover up is, there's been nearly a seamless cover up of everything, and then during this Trump election, we're starting to see this whole deep state, this hidden government within a government, this global government within.
Absolutely. It's never been more visible. You're right.
They're showing their hand. Yeah, the slips, their slips are showing, basically. But, it's very curious. The last place that they're going to show anything is in the nuclear industry. Isn't that amazing? That's sort of like one of their core. It's like a vault, okay? It's like a vault in the bank. It's the last thing you're going to see.
That's called a sacred cow.
Exactly. I think the Turkey event, the failed coup, sort of began this knockdown of the dominoes now. The house of cards is starting to fall now that the Turkish government has exposed this, the whole thing is Operation Gladio, NATO, U.S. intelligence, U.S. Air Force. I mean, this whole process has begun.
Right.
And now we got this mini-me, Dr. Evil's mini-me coming out to challenge Trump. Guy works for clandestine operations for 10 years, Africa, Middle East, and Asia. Then he goes to work for Goldman Sachs. I mean, come on, what is Goldman Sachs, right? What is another one of those vaults of a deep state? And then he goes works for the UN Refugee Agency. And this just absolutely proves that the European refugee crisis was created, conceived right from the start by the, U.S. intelligence, British intelligence, Goldman Sachs, Clinton Foundation, and George Soros. What proofs do we need? We have Dr. Evil's mini-me. Evan McMullen running for president against Donald Trump, so supported by the Mormons, by obviously Goldman and company, UN and so on.
This is
what we're up against in Fukushima. This is the point we've been trying to say. This is the core. Yeah. Nuclear is a core asset of the deep state, or you want to call it the intelligence state, the strategic global government that's trying to control and manipulate everything and everyone and control information. And I do recommend, yesterday I saw the new Jason Bourne movie, talks about agents disappearing. Dead agents are everywhere still alive killing people. Everyone should go see that film to understand how the deep
dead agents
works.
Are still alive killing people. It sounds a little familiar, doesn't it?
Doesn't it sound like New York? Now, we're not talking about Henry Shark, but this guy, Barry Lee Bush. That story has been sort of blurred out of the press, right?
Hold on. Yoshi, hold on one second. Dana, I want to make sure you're there and welcome you, back. How are you doing?
Good. Listen to you guys right now.
Good. I want to do a little bit with Yoshi on this Barry Lee Bush thing. Did you see that story, by the way, the attempted assassination on Trump a week ago tomorrow?
No, I haven't.
All right. Well, listen, because this is a big deal, and we are going to hopefully blow this thing wide open. We'll see. Anyway.
They need to work on all sides, right? Kill the other side. Keep up the chaos. Keep up the wars. Keep up the arms sales. This is a situation we've been up against. And we're unfortunately, you and I and Dana have been hitting the very hardest core, the source of depleted uranium, right? The what's inside aircraft carriers and submarines with the missiles, okay? That are fired at Baghdad and places, okay? Fired at Afghanistan. We're up against the nuclear core. That's why You know, we just sort of bounce off. You know, this is they don't let anything through there. That's the hardest. You know, that is the sort of inner circle, the sanctum of these people.
Yeah. All right.
Which
very
is,
good.
University of Chicago.
Yeah, a lot of it there.
The basis of nuclear. Yeah.
Yeah, it came out of
Hiroshima bomb. Go ahead, Chip.
That's where it came out of. Yeah. You're right. Let me point out one thing here.
That's where you'll find
law school, the University of Chicago.
Say again.
There you go, Dan. You nailed it. Who went to law school at Chicago?
Oh yes, yeah? Oh yes.
Barack.
Yeah, that's.
Right?
He was fast tracked, put right through. He probably never went to class a day in his life, and didn't he work?
They drill them. Don't touch the nuclear industry. Don't touch.
Oh,
the
they never.
The
they never do.
You know,
never talk about it. Never.
Yeah. Yeah.
Not a word. Never once have you heard anything substantial from this government about Fukushima, about the extinction event that is now clearly unfolding. Go to the top of the Fukushima nuclear catastrophe featured story box on the right-hand side, where you can find all these programs. They're updated routinely every Monday. And look at the first story. I want to thank all of you who have participated in this, and I invite all of you to look at the first story in the Fukushima box. Dana was the one who broke this issue. And the story is entitled, No Bugs, No Birds. As we've warned, extinction is here. Please contribute observations. And you can click on that and see the emails that folks have sent in. Good people who have noticed and taken note of the fact that there are very few birds and virtually no insects left in their areas where they're commonly or loaded with them. Yeah, have you seen that link, Dana?
I have so. Yes, Jeff, thank you.
Yeah, I've sent you a few of the emails, forwarded them to you. It's exactly as you said, exactly as you predicted and forecast, and it is a catastrophe.
Yeah, and it's only because we've done the whole coast, so we know. Hey, I went over to Snopes and looked up Fukushima, and the first one they showed us was the tsunami map, and they debunked that as a radiation map, and then they left it at that. They never bothered saying, wait a second, France modeled the ocean, NOAA modeled the ocean, the Norwegian Institute for Air Research modeled the ocean, Austria, all these different institutions modeled the ocean and modeled the atmosphere. Uh-huh. They didn't bother, and they only got 5 articles there, but I mean, they are with a map of the tsunami, and they debunked that. So yeah, Snopes is as dirty as they get. There's beyond any shadow of a doubt. I'm going to drop them on their head a few times for that one.
Yeah, well, there'll be more coming.
Yeah, I'm sure.
It's run.
Yeah,
it's,
I know. That's why you looked at that, Dana, because I haven't really looked at their Fukushima. You know, I mean, the debunkers attack it from different ways. So I'll say it was a nuclear attack. It was a HARP attack. I mean, they come up with all kinds of outrageous things, right, in the name of truth.
Oh, it
to
is.
To attack, you know. A scientific approach that we've been trying to take as best we can, citizen science, yes, but we do try to, you know, do our best to be very moderate about our findings for the past 5 years, as you have. You know, you haven't, you name exactly that how many species are left, how many are gone. Yeah, you know, you're not saying everything is dead, you know, so.
That's right.
But their approach is either catastrophic or nothing has happened, or, right. You know, and they'll switch sides, too. I'm really glad you looked at Snopes. That's something you need to look at, these deep bunker sites. You know, we've been trying to collect
stories.
The names of all these people. Yeah.
That's okay.
That's why they dropped it. They're told to drop it. Yeah, don't bring attention to it.
Yeah, I'll just rip them up anyway if something to do, like you say. But they're an easy job. I just looked at them, so not very worried about that. I see thousands came out in China.
Say that again. They did. Yes. Thousands demonstrated in China, Yoshi. You saw that.
No one arrested.
Big demonstration, and they were chanting, we know about Fukushima, the Chinese. We know.
Wow, and they're planning on building 8 or 9 plants here. Go ahead.
Well, that's good. I hope they don't go to Japan and eat the food anymore, because they're going to kill themselves and warn the rest of the world. They should warn the rest of the world, because a lot of Chinese tourists have gone there. I know they're falling sick. If they put it together, that would be the hugest testimony, okay? Hugest testimony against what's going on. The Japan's program of poisoning the world with radioactive food, exporting everything.
That's what they're doing, and we've got it over here in the States.
To confirm what you've been doing about, what you're claiming about the birds, you know, strangely, Thailand is way the far off, okay? But I've noticed we'd have these pesky starlings come, you know, and they would just, you know, just fill the telephone wires and trees and the sidewalks and some places where they would land. It would be just pure white with bird dung. It would be like a phosphate mine, okay, or the guano mine. And I noticed all the sidewalks are clean. Okay, well, I'm not a real starling watcher, but I've noticed I don't hear them anymore.
I haven't, Yoshi. I've been out working outside when I can get off the desk. I head out, and I have not seen any starlings, any sparrows, any finches, any birds. I've seen two or three jays, one crow, and that's it. Used to see flocks of starlings whipping through the air, turning directions and making noise. Red-winged blackbirds, beautiful birds. No more. No more. I'm telling you, there's none left.
I tell you, that's happening down in Thailand. This is tropical paradise for birds. I'm noticing, the birds. What's happened, you know? There used to be so many of them. And now the population maybe is one-tenth. It was one of the reasons for being here. Yeah, there's so many wild birds, and now I hardly see one anymore.
What's that, Dana?
Typhoons and the tropical storms. There, a lot of them are going right over Japan, right off of Japan, accelerating and heading down there, and they're depositing stupid amounts of radiation. But it's terrifying to hear you say that. Go ahead. That's interesting. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it really is expanding this zone, this circle. Then I met a friend, you know, he's from near Brisbane, you know, Byron Bay. And then he showed me a map below Byron Bay. He says he's not feeling too good, okay? He says he's not been very feeling fatigued lately. I go, uh-oh, just like my own family members are feeling fatigued and they're in highly radioactive areas, or increasingly radioactive areas. We shouldn't say highly, it's not high yet, but it's increasing. He showed me on the map. There's this radar circle, he says, a giant radar circle. I have to have him send the map to you, Jeff. And then I said, oh, my God, look at the circle. Where's Byron Bay? I said, it's right outside the circle. No wonder you're not feeling good. They got some sort of radar system. They call it radar, which apparently is blocking radiation. You can see it on the map, this sort of green, fuzzy stuff all around. So there must, I said, is there a military base there? He says, well, there's a lot of food production. I said, yeah, Australia's a desert country. They got to protect their little pockets of farmland that sustains the country. You know, it's spreading everywhere.
Well, go and look at the top of the Fukushima nuclear catastrophe box in the right column. Top story, no birds, no bugs. Please read what people have sent in and make observations from where you are and send those in as well. I'd like to add to it because this is a clear trend. It's not a joke, and it is a disaster. We got you look outside. Think if 10 years ago, when you were thinking about birds and insects and life, if you have any ability to get outside at all, and go out and look now. See, tell me what you see. I know what I see. I don't see anything anymore. It's weird. It's just weird, and it's not encouraging.
There was a lady who wrote a book in the UK about 40,000 species, I guess it was, over a few decades in her garden. And altogether, I've seen maybe 30 species in the last 2 years. And none of them were, like lots of them or something.
You know what we need to do? We need to get in touch with some bird watchers. They got big bird watching clubs and ask them what they're seeing. They do counts and everything else.
Well, watch out. I found out bird watching clubs are often under some sort of control.
Oh, really?
During the avian influenza crisis in Southeast Asia, I contacted a bunch of them. A lot more British. The British are like created the twitches, the twitching clubs. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to get information on how farmers were poisoning the big storks that are coming in, because something like 30,000 of them were killed in the space of 3 weeks, okay? And I was out there, you know, that's what brought me to Thailand with avian influenza. I was out there doing scientific seminars to fight avian influenza for the poultry industry, which is out in these swamp areas, you know? And you can see all the storks and cranes out there. So, and then this club was really hostile in this reaction, because I said, I would like to get your observations on declining bird species, which has been reported by Thai ornithologists that there's been these kill-offs, okay? And the bird watchers refused to cooperate.
Yeah? Oh, interesting. Very interesting. Dana, what's up?
British, right?
Yeah, all right. Well, that's a duly noted. Thank you for that. Tell me what's going on up there. We're at the toward the end of summer now. The life cycle of spring, summer, fall, loaded with life, nature. What's happening up there?
Yeah, she's falling apart, and everybody's starting to wake up at the same time and understand it, that there's no life.
They are and seeing that, like, it
the
finally.
Whales
not the media, porpoises. But the people.
the whales and the porpoises and everything, they're way up the food chain. So if you see one, that's exciting. But the reality of it was, normally 8 die a year on the coastline. We find last year was 48. And, you know, the day are the last ones to go. The fish are the last ones to go. They don't die of cancers because they don't live long enough. But they bioaccumulate around 15,000 times the radiation that's around them. And so we're seeing that, you know, how we covered the stories of the mussels being full of cancer, so you can't go near them. But yet we got the pictures of the whole coastline of the mussels missing. And, like, I wish I had what it takes to go do the coastline again, but I don't. I'm not capable. I don't know how I done it the last time.
I don't know how you did either.
Yeah, we had to know, right? I had no options.
You're the man, the one man on the planet who's brought the truth home. You exposed the whole thing. And it's only worse. You don't have to go do it again. It's just gotten worse.
I got to go to court next week on Monday, and then trials in September. And so I can't afford it.
Do you have reason?
I'll stick a plug out there. Yeah, people can donate.
Do you have
people
reasonable?
Go ahead, Jeff.
Tell me about your legal representation. Do you have anybody?
No, I'm going to meet that on Monday next Monday. They're going to have to appoint one for me. I tried 16 lawyers. Nobody would take the case.
Oh, they've been told.
Three had said they took the case. Then they didn't contact me. I contacted, finally got hold of one of them. They said, they can't take the case, and then they just hung up on me. And I told the judge that. And so then the judge, I was supposed to have a lawyer a long time back. They kept saying they're going to appoint that lawyer to me before the next time I had to go to court. I went to court 5 times, and now I got to go again. And then just 3 days in September. I don't think they're going to show up. That's why they're doing it. I think it's just, like you say, a slap suit meant to bankrupt me and drag me into another jurisdiction and everything else and all that misery causes you. Plus, they smeared me in the media. But I'm going down to defend myself at all costs. And, you know, these people, they left the country. One of the people that had me charged had left the country before I was picked up and charged. And so hasn't come back and won't come back until the trial.
Uh-huh.
That was the one that was at University of Victoria. So what does that tell you? They've never showed up at any of the trials, mm-hmm. any of the 5 court appearances.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And
this is so repulsive. They're going after the one guy who took this whole thing on his shoulders for all of us, Dana Durnford.
No, I don't mind saying that. Sometimes you don't want to, but sometimes you got to.
No, it's the truth. Nothing wrong with the truth.
60 days on that ocean by myself, mostly by myself. And I mean, originally we had, you know, 3 guys on the beach plus me.
Yeah.
But that was untenable. It was just too much money. And, you know, we would never get the whole coastline done if I had kept doing that. And so, 5 months by myself, people, and include myself, will never, because I don't want to remember, but I have it documented in video and pictures and ring. Mm-hmm. And that was a heartbreaking trip. That was a brutalizing trip. And I was demonized and viciously assaulted the whole time I was gone. And while I was and up there in certain places, I was attacked. But these people that are with the nuclear industry, what they've done to me on those expeditions in order to try to demonize me, when I come ashore, have me arrested. That is unforgivable. That is unbelievable that people are actually like this. Of course, I know they are. I know the misery all over this planet. But on something so serious and something so important and something with so much impact and the extinction event that has already played out, that these people who've done it to me done it for a dollar. They weren't the players, right? They done it for a dollar.
Right.
And it's just disheartening to know that that exists. And there's 2,000 of these PR firms we know about for the nuclear industry. But it is unbelievable. You know, it's heartbreaking what they've done to me and what they continue to do to me. when all I'm like you, I'm like Yoshi. It's time to have a conversation. We got to have that conversation. We can't wait any longer. And we're not waiting any longer. We've been doing a steady, but it's time for everybody on this planet now to have a say, and they will. And it's not, we wanted to say of lucid, not anger and chaos. And so the longer we wait, the more realistic that one becomes. And with the insects dying, with the birds die off, we count 11 species out of over 300, over 260 days and 15,000 miles. And then Yoshi has walked the shoreline. Jeff has reports from all around the country. I have been relentless collecting it. I have thousands and thousands of peer-reviewed studies on this stuff. There is no illusion about this stuff. Every animal for 5 years died, and in radiation studies for 70 years. So at what point would they give it up? Well, they won't.
No, they never will. Oh, no.
They won't give it up. No, we got to make them give it up.
Well, that's why this guy, Evan McMullen, you know, the anti-Trump candidate, after he left clandestine services, you know, killing people for the CIA, he goes to Goldman, and then he works at the UN on refugee issues, but also on energy issues. In other words, he's another nuclear
man. Yeah, there's another nuclear connection. Right?
Yeah, so these are the kind of people that Dana's talking about. They're not phantasms. You know, this McMullen is one of them. These are trained killers who've done this for decades in these wars, in these third world countries where you can get away with it, okay? They come back to their homelands, and they're ready to take out any opposition to the secret government and to the big bankers that they work for. So we got to be aware of what's going on. Dana needs a defense fund, especially among Canadians. I've got to now rally to his defense and start to think, you know, legal, paralegal, if you're not a lawyer, okay, at least you should get a team of paralegals. You know, people who are students who have studied law, law secretaries.
They can do a lot. Work you're
together.
Right.
Great fun. Yeah, to begin to build a legal defense. Mm-hmm. And I shouldn't even say legal defense. It has to be a legal offense. We got to take this guy, these guys on and show that there's an industry, a hidden hand, and state security services behind that. And the state security is using veterans. They're using contractors, okay? Uh-huh. Even more illegal than, you know, illegal instruments of state who are trying to terrorize environmental activists for telling people the truth about what's harming them. And this is not about Canada. Well, Canada is implicated because of the uranium. This is about Japan, a foreign country dumping nuclear waste onto Canada, the pristine shore of Canada. So by all rights, you know, the Canadian government is violating its own charter to defend its
Absolutely.
Own country. Okay.
And same thing with America. Right? Same thing with the U.S. is the same. We are being constantly attacked with Japanese radiation. This is an assault on our environment, on our human life potential. It's all coming down. When people walk out their doors in the next year or two or three, and notice when it hits them, you know, they've heard about no bugs. They go out and they don't see any bugs, and they don't see any birds. They don't hear any more birds. And I'm getting emails from people who say the very same thing, and from all over the country. They're gone. And when they wake up and realize that there are no more insects to speak of, a few species, no more birds, maybe a few species, I bet scrub jays, that's about it. They're going to say, geez, what happened here? And we've been telling you, all you folks, this from day one, what the potential was, what the future is, and now what in fact is manifesting. And it is really ugly. It's horrible. And we're not going to recover from it. There's no recovering from this, is there, Dana?
You got to get off the coast of the Pacific Ocean, Pacific Rim Nations, yeah. So we're in trouble. We're in trouble.
Well,
we should have been gone.
Well, Dana, I just hope that your defense brief. You know, the reason I think you need to get a defense team who knows how to write defense briefs, okay? And a legal team could begin to be the core of an educational device, too, about how, you know, the laws are supposed to defend, you know, Western democracies like Canada from this sort of, you know, environmental warfare and how they're failing, okay, under their own laws, all right, and under international law. We just had this UN Law of the Sea panel, right? Rule against China and the South China Sea. Where is the UN rule of law, law of the Sea panel on Fukushima? Which country? It just takes one country, like the Philippines, that it takes one country to say Japan is contaminating the entire Pacific Ocean and our economy and our public health is being harmed. It takes one country to say
nobody's doing it.
Ruling nobody's from doing the Hague.
It. Yeah, and it, yeah, we absolutely.
Very important data. Absolutely.
I hear you. I hear you.
The whole process.
Let me say something for anyone living in Canada. If you're an attorney or you know an attorney who's not part of the system, who's got some guts and some backbone, we need a pro bono attorney to come in. And this is a landmark case. This is not a lightweight deal. They're trying to make an example of one of the great heroes of our time. And I say that absolutely with honesty. He is. And they're trying to take him down. And we can't allow this to happen. He is the source for information. He was the one who sounded the alarm about insects and bugs. He was right. This is a couple of years ago. And now the birds and the insects are gone. Those two links in the food chain, the chain of life, are gone. And they're not going to come back. And you're going to walk out, all of you, and eventually in North America, you won't hear a bird. You won't see any more birds. And you won't have any bugs. Oh, you say, hey, great, no flies. I don't see any more flies. I did see a butterfly today. Thank God, I saw one butterfly. But the bugs are almost gone. The swarms are gone. They're not there. No more bats, gone.
They were gone last year.
Yes, they were.
They were gone last year.
I didn't notice it.
Gone a couple of years before, for all we know. But 2014, they were mostly gone. That was confirmed. 2015, now 2016, it's even worse. And it's more still, more quiet. And, like, I got 35-mile lake up here, and I've been up 7-8 times, and I counted one bird.
One, you saw one bird. I believe it.
One bird.
Here's the key, folks. Look at your car windshield. Look at the front end. Look at the bumper. Look for bugs on your headlights. You're not going to see many anymore. Now, there are pockets. There are pockets like Southwest Florida still loaded with insects, tropics, subtropics. There are areas that are still reasonably normal, but there are other areas that have been hit hard and there's nothing left to speak of. Read the emails. It's right there at the top of the box.
The entire coast of Canada and British Columbia is gone.
All gone. It's sterile. Sterile.
That's fact.
And
it's up on my side.
Now, the other thing about Dana's case, why it's so important to have a strong defense is because we need a countersuit against the University of Victoria and the government of British Columbia.
Oh, perfect. Yeah.
British. So that then we can begin the ball rolling eventually for under the law of the sea, right? A law of the sea counterpage against those parties for being part of an economic conspiracy to thwart Canadian law and the fundamental security, the defense law of Canada, everything, environmental laws, the violation of multiple laws of internet, and then this has to be then taken by, and once you win that, then maybe the Canadian government will be forced to take this case to the Hague, the international law.
What bothers me, final note, what bothers me, Yoshi, I don't know if you've heard anything more, if those Japanese continue to talk about building a concrete sarcophagus over the wreckage of that plant, That's the end. That's the end. All they're going to do is sanctify, certify, and guarantee that...
stay on that site.
That's it. That's it.
Yeah.
Final comment, Dana?
I say at the end of the year, my predictions, unfortunately, are going to be true. There will be nothing left on this coastline, including whales. And that doesn't look like it's going to change. It looks like that's exactly what's going to happen. And so it's going to be a tough year for everybody because you can't hide it by the end of the year is how I see this.
Oh, I agree. All right. Take care, my friend. Talk to you next week.
Yeah. Hugs for you. Hugs for you, Yoshi. Take care, folks.
Thanks, Dana.
Good luck in hearings. I hope you find a decent lawyer. I hope so.
Yeah. One lawyer with some principle. Who cares? That's all it'll take. All right. Yoshi, we covered a lot of ground this hour. There's a lot going on. Very ugly, very dark. Be careful there. They tried to take me out. They tried to take you out.
Let's put it this way. It's either assassination of what's left of democracy or the birth pangs of the rebirth of democracy. It's one or the others. Everything is still on the balance. This is going to be a battle for months now. This is going to be a real 100-day 90-day campaign is begun.
Yeah, we'll see. All right, you take care. Talk to you soon. All right, there goes Yoshi and Dana, and we will be back tomorrow night in 21 hours. Thanks for the time tonight. 3 hours, a lot of information. Hope we made it palatable and understandable. It's very complicated, and there's more happening all the time. Let's watch Hillary's health. I frankly hope it takes her out of the contest for president of the United States of America. She is not worthy on every possible account. All right. Talk to you tomorrow night. See you then.